डिस्कस और अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ द डेटा स्ट्रक्चर. डेटा स्ट्रक्चर, व्हाई वी आर यूजिंग द डेटा स्ट्रक्चर. सो एक्चुअली बेसिकली इट इज़ अ जस्ट अ वे टू ऑर्गेनाइज द डेटा, बिकॉज व्हेन वी आर डीलिंग विद द इंफॉर्मेशन वी हैव टू ऑर्गेनाइज आर डेटा, वी हैव टू लॉजिकली स्ट्रक्चर्ड आर डेटा सो दैट वी कैन डू द ऑपरेशन लाइक एडिशन, मॉडिफिकेशन, डिलीशन, सर्चिंग. That means delete. We can delete the record. We can perform the searching operation. We can display the information. We can do the editing in that information because it is just a way to organize how we are manipulating or arranging the data so that we can effectively use them. For that, we are using the concept of stack and queue. These are just a logically way to arrange the data, nothing else. In the stack and queue, we will learn how we can arrange the data and accordingly how we can retrieve the data, do the changes in the data. That means how many ways we can do the manipulation in that data. Stack basically what is? It is a linear structure. आप इसको ऐसा समझ सकते हो कि this is basically a list type of structure. And in this, we are maintaining the record in the LIFO order. I can give you example for that. Suppose when we are arranging the information in the form, normally in the list, we are arranging the information in the horizontal manner. But in the stack, we are arranging the information in the vertical order. Suppose in the earlier in the list we are inserting first element, then after that we are inserting second element, then third and fourth. All these things will show in the horizontal manner, but when we are maintaining the structure in the stack, this is just a assumption that we are manipulating or arranging the data in the vertical order so that it will be convenient for us to understand the concept. List is a concept of the static data structure and stack gives us the information, or it is basically a dynamic data structure, because when we can add as many as records according to our own requirement, we don't have to fix the size as we are doing in the list also. In this, whatsoever we are entering at the last will move out first, and after that we can't take any element from in between the list. If we have to take out, suppose if I want to take out the 2 number from this list, for that I have to take out 12 out, then I have to take out 10, then I have to take out 9, and after that I can remove only the second value from the list. That is why it is following the LIFO order, last in first out order. In the there are 2 rules when we are maintaining the information. When we are removing anything, we are using the word pop. Pop means that shows that I have maintained my information, I have maintained my data in the form of stack, and in the stack I am deleting, I am removing some information. When we are removing anything from the stack, we are using the word pop. Pop itself shows कि आपकी इंफॉर्मेशन स्टैक में स्टोर है. जब हम कोई इसमें एलिमेंट ऐड करते हैं, फॉर दैट वी आर यूजिंग द वर्ड पुश. पुश वर्ड इटसेल्फ शोज कि दैट आई हैव स्टोर्ड, आई एम स्टोरिंग द इंफॉर्मेशन इनटू द स्टैक. आफ्टर दैट देयर आर फ्यू ऑपरेशन. पीक मींस आई एम जस्ट इंस्पेक्टिंग और आई एम जस्ट चेकिंग कि एट व्हाट वैल्यू आई हैव, माय पॉइंटर इज एट व्हिच पोजीशन. If my list is full, then it will show the overflow. If there are no element in my list, then we are using the word underflow. Underflow shows that my list is empty. That means my stack is empty. There are few examples related to the stack. When you are reversing a line, suppose you are writing any sentence in the, and when you want to reverse that particular sentence, it shows that I am performing the operation related to stack. You can reverse a word, the same thing. You can take a stack of books or plates. if you are arranging that, this is the simplest example. Suppose when you are wearing, as a girl, have you seen so many ladies when they are wearing the bangles? And if they have to remove the bangles, then for that first they have to remove the last bangle first out. That means that is a part of the stack, that we can't take out any bangle from in between the wrist. If we want to take out, then we have to take out the last added bangles first. This is just an example. Let's see through the example coded form ki how we can create a stack. Stack is just a list. You don't have to worry about ki what is stack and how we can implement the things. This is just a stack, and when we have to perform any operation in the stack, it will work like normal list. Suppose if I want to add 5 elements, or you want to add the 3 elements, that is up to you how many elements you want to add in that stack. And if you want to add, suppose here I am entering integer in form of enter roll number. Suppose these two things I want to store into the stack simultaneously, and another I just want to add the name of the student, enter your name. These two things I just want to store into the stack. Same way, you just have to use the append function, just specify the stack name. This is just a simple list, and then you can store the information. We already know ki we can't store multiple values in a by using the append function. If we want to store, for that we can use the list concept. I can show you the example also. Suppose this is my list. If there are many elements, and if I want to use the append function for that, append function. By default, append function adds only a one element. If I want to add multiple elements in my list, then I can use the append function. And if I want to use the append function, for that I can add multiple elements, but these will store in the form of nested list. Now you can see, whenever, because there is one more function, extend also. Extend function, or the syntax of the extend function and append function, when we are adding multiple elements are the same. When we are adding multiple elements are the same, but when we are inserting the elements through extend function, then it will add the elements at the end, but in the loose form as we have added the other elements. Baki jaise elements add kiye waise hi. But jab hum append function use karte hain, tab usme jo elements aapke add hote hain, wo aapke nested list ki form mein add hote hain. If you want to add multiple elements, that is why here I have used this concept, so that I can make a list of these things. This is the main concept related to the stack. Now your stack has been added. Now if you want to make a function for this, then you can make a function also. Suppose if I am making, because in the exam different type of questions they are asking. In the next video we will discuss the questions related to the stack. Yeah, how the different type of questions they are asking in the exam, and how you have to deal it. So I have added the information into my stack, and after that if I want to call this function, then I can call the function also. It will take 3 values from me. For the time being I am just using a name, so that I can add the things. What is the difference? Okay, I have used single quote here. Now you can add roll number, and then you can add any name. Then again, you can add. I have added. Now you can see ki now, ma'am, how we can show the, because it has not shown us anything. Then you can use the print function also, because in the entire code I have not used the print function, so obviously it will not show anything on the screen. Either you can use the print function also, then it will, when you will add the information, it will show you the information on the screen. None, because the function is not returning anything. So push is returning, but we have to show something in the list form. Then we have to use another function for that. We can use disp function so that we can display the information related to the stack whatsoever we have created here. Because we know that when we are inserting anything in the stack, the stack is storing the information in the vertical order. That means whatsoever we have stored at the end, it will show us in the beginning. For that we can use, because we are displaying everything in the reverse order. That is why we have to use the reverse concept for this. And whenever we are using the range function, we have to use the list name or string or tuple name along with the index value of the counter. Then we can show the information. Now let's see how it will show us the information. I am calling these two functions accordingly. You can see the things. Roll number 1, suppose I am entering this. Now 3, this is thing. Now you can see whatsoever have I entered at the end, it has shown us in the beginning also. If you want to show everything in the same line, then you can show by using the end symbol also, end parameter of the print function. Or if you want to show some symbols along with that, then you can use also. That is up to you how you are presenting in the exam. You just have to write the code related to the push function and the display function. This we have already discussed. Now we were discussing the concept related to the pop function. That means when we have to delete something from the stack. When we are deleting something, we know that the by default, when we are deleting something, suppose is there is no list. Suppose if I am taking the same list for the time being. Okay, I have not stored anything. Suppose this is my list. If I have to delete something, so by default, if I am using the pop function, then if I am not specifying any in position in the parenthesis, then by default it will remove the last element. Each and every time, whenever you are using the pop function, if you are not specifying anything in the parenthesis, then it will remove the last element for that. Now you can see. Now if you are specifying any index value, obviously it will delete that value. Index in the pop function always takes the index value. Here I am deleting 2. 2 means this 2 is at which position? This is at the 1 position, because list starts from the 0. Now you can see. So 2 means 0, 1, 2. Okay, sorry, that was my mistake. Got it? Now the same concept we will discuss here also. How we can delete the things? First, if we want to check the things, whether my stack is empty or not, then you can use this thing also. It shows that my list stack is empty. You can display the message also. Underflow, either you can use underflow itself shows that there no element in the list. If there are some element, then you can delete that element from the last. Now let's discuss. I am just calling the pop function here. Whenever you are using the pop function, please give some different name to the pop function. You can change the case, because by default there is a pop function also in the Python. Now after deleting, I just want to display the elements. Okay, if there are certain elements still exist in the stack or not. Now again, roll number 1, this is another roll number, this is third. Pop is not defined. Stack for loop or the pop is not defined. I have deleted the element. pop. Okay, that was my mistake because I have changed the name of the function and here I have forgot to specify it. I'm changing the things. Now you can see ki these are my list, and after deletion it has shown me these two elements because it has been already deleted by the elements. Now you can display here also after deletion. It will show you the other things. Let's disk one. Let's start it again. Now you can see after deletion it has been removed. We will discuss another way also, other methods also, how the question is coming in your exam. So that's all for today's video. The rest of the things we will discuss in the next video. Thank you.